Hi there, this is Luv Johar, and in this particular training video we will try to understand what exactly do we mean by risk analysis, which is the second main part of the overall risk assessment process. So the main key question that we should ask when we think about risk analysis is how could we protect any sort of environment without being completely aware of the emerging threats and without understanding all the variables such as the likelihood of occurrence and the estimated level of impact of any kind of risk that may surface in that particular environment. So risk analysis is used to estimate the potential risk by asking the primarily couple of questions which we'll be discussing over here. So the first question that you can ask is, we need to understand what are the chances of this event actually taking place in the future. That is, what is the probability that this particular event will happen in the future? So if by any chance if the event occurs, this is the second question, that if by any chance the event, if it occurs, what kind of impact would it have? For example, impact would be either defined in terms of financial loss to the organization or reputation loss to the organization, etc. So as you can see, that risk analysis process mainly involves around two keywords, that is probability and impact. So let's try to understand by taking some real examples what exactly do these terms mean. So probability of something is nothing but the likelihood of its occurrence. Probability can be defined in terms of an event in terms of unlikely to occur, possibility to occur, or highly likely to occur. So probability can be defined in these terms. And impact of something can be defined in terms of negligible impact, moderate impact, or severe impact. So risk analysis mainly falls into two categories. It can be either quantitative analysis or qualitative risk analysis. So now you must be thinking, what does quantitative and qualitative risk analysis means? So first let's try to understand the quantitative approach. So using the quantitative approach, it basically involves a statistical study of all the old past records such as incidents, real impacts, and any other pertinent information that you have registered in terms of the old risk that you have faced over the past years in your particular organization. So the quantitative approach is entirely dependent, as you can see, on the level of historical data that you have available. Meaning which, if you don't have any data and the data is not enough and accurate, then it is not practical to use this quantitative approach at all. So after that, let's try to understand what is the qualitative methodology. So this is more simpler to implement and provide sufficient information for risk treatment for most of the organizations. Qualitative analysis uses a scale based on qualifying attributes that describe the magnitude of both, potential impacts and the likelihood of occurrence. For example, you can adopt a scale that will classify risks as very low, low, moderate, high, or very high. So once you have selected the methodology that best suits your needs, you should be able to calculate the level of impact and likelihood of occurrence and create a risk estimation, which is the main overall objective of risk analysis process. So that's it for this particular training video. I request you to please subscribe to my channel if you are really interested to study more about ISO 27001 and understand its implementation. So information security management system is a very vast topic, so please ensure that you subscribe to get the most knowledge out of these videos. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below and I will be really happy to respond back. This is Luv Johar. Thank you.